Hey guys, how's it going? I still feel a little beard. Ba-dum-bum. Okay, check out this epic new model that I just designed. It took forever. It is an Aum symbol, and it's also a finger puppet.
It's an Aum symbol, which is an important symbol in Hinduism. I think you probably heard it. It's pronounced Aum. It's from the Devanagari script, which is a script used in India and other parts of the world. And just in case you're wondering, no, I'm not Hindu. But just like when I made the crescent, moon, and star, that didn't mean I was Muslim. But rather, I'm just trying to respect different cultures around the world. And in particular, India. Surprisingly, my channel receives about as many views from India as from the United States. So for my Indian friends, this is for you, and for whoever else this symbol resonates with. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. So for this model, I used a 10-inch square. You could try from a 6-inch square, but I recommend using a bigger sheet. Let's begin colored side up and fold in half. This will make a colored symbol on a white background. Make sure to make really precise folds and crease sharply. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. Remember, this is a really complex model, so if you're new to folding, I don't recommend attempting this model. But if you're up for the challenge, then let's continue. And now unfold and rotate and fold in half. And now open the flap and put your finger all the way inside and flatten it on the existing creases. And fold this flap to the right. And turn over. So here we have half of a water bomb base. Let's fold this flap up to this point. And open the flap and squash it to here. Now fold this flap up so that this edge aligns perfectly with this crease. And repeat on this side. And unfold these two flaps and fold this front flap to this point. Okay, now let's refold these two flaps and rotate. Okay, now comes a kind of tricky step. Let's open this flap up and open this pocket up and fold this flap to the crease and close it back up like that. And repeat on this side. So open this pocket and fold on the existing crease like this and flatten. And rotate. And now fold this flap up to the two points, like that. And make that fold really sharp and unfold and open a little bit just so that we can take this flap and fold it down right on this crease. Make sure that the corner lands on the crease. And bring it back down and flatten it like it was. Okay, now we're going to rotate. All right, now we're going to make the little stroke that goes on the bottom of the dot. So let's fold this flap up. Now, if we just fold it like that, then you see there's no thickness. But if we fold it a little bit further, then it opens up here and we can squash it like that. Now that would be a narrow line. If you fold it a little bit further, then it'll be a little bit wider. And I like the point to come about there. So it's like that. And now we're going to do the same sort of thing over here, but a little bit different. Let's fold it so that the fold ends up right at this point. And this time, instead of squashing it like this, we want it to be a blunt point. So open here and squash it down like this. And you can adjust those to taste. I think that looks pretty nice. If you want this corner to curve up a little bit more, then what you can do is, it's kind of a challenging step. What you can do is grab it so that the two raw edges touch and collapse it so that this edge is parallel to this edge. So it's like that. And now you can grab the raw edge and just pull it down a little bit. Like that. So there's a tiny pleat right there. And that's what makes the step so hard. If you can't do it, then, well, that's just fine, like it was. But I think it looks a little bit nicer, like that. Okay, now let's rotate. And let's make a paper airplane fold on this flap. So fold it like this. And same thing on the other side. So it's like this. So this point is a 90 degree angle. Now let's pull this flap up to taste. I think, yeah, on this point is fine. Or maybe a little less, however you want. And I'm gonna just adjust this so that these edges touch, and same here. Okay, fair enough. All right. Now, let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And unfold and fold this edge to the crease. And unfold just the front flap so it's like this. And now we need to invert, we need to turn this point inside out. So open here just enough so that you can flip this around like that. So it looks like this. Let's turn over. And now fold this flap so that this edge aligns with the crease. Don't flatten this point yet. And turn back over. And now you can flatten it so that the corner lands on this edge. Like that. And that's all we're gonna do right now in this area. Let's work over here. So let's fold this flap up to this point. And unfold. And now we're going to divide this edge into 12. So let's first divide it into thirds. So fold it about like this and over. We're just making pinch marks, so we're not folding all the way along it. We just want to fiddle with the folds so that all three of these edges have equal length. That's pretty good. And make the pinch marks like that and unfold. And now we're going to divide this segment into four. So pinch along this crease and fold this corner to the pinch mark. And make another pinch mark there and unfold. And now fold it again so that this corner goes to the pinch mark. And make a new pinch mark and unfold and rotate. And now we're going to fold this flap up so that the fold goes to the last pinch mark. And we want this corner to land on the crease. Okay, and unfold. And now we're going to reverse this flap. So open here, stick your hand inside, and this is the crease we need to reverse. And push the flap in and close it. And rotate. And now fold this flap up on the crease and unfold it. And now fold the flap up to this edge so that this is perpendicular to this edge. It's parallel to this line. And when it looks good, then make the fold. Okay, now comes a kind of tricky step. What we're going to do is push in here, right on this crease. And we need to make a fold that goes from this point to this edge. So it goes from this edge, it goes underneath, and it ends up at this point. Once you have that fold, then you can flatten it, and the other fold will just happen. All right, now let's fold this flap down so that the fold goes through this point, and this edge is about parallel to this edge. This is kind of to taste, but do something about like that. Okay, now comes another tricky step. We're going to take this point. We're going to take this edge and just make a little tiny pleat. So it's about like this. The object is we want this edge to be about parallel to this edge. So it's like that. And if you want, you can try to just kind of slant this edge a little bit. So that really is a pretty small pleat right there. But anyway, hope you guys were able to do that. If not, like it was before, is fine. Okay. And let's rotate. Now fold this flap up so that the corner touches this point. And unfold it and fold the flap to the crease. And unfold. And now fold this crease to this crease. So line up the creases, and you can also fold this edge onto itself. Like that. And unfold, and fold this flap to the crease. and unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this flap down and fold it up so that the fold goes between this point and this point. So it's diagonal like this. And now fold down on this crease and fold up so that the fold goes between this point and this point. And fold on this crease. And now fold so that the fold goes between this point and, well, at least on my model, this point ends up on this crease. Ooh, and this point also ends up on this edge. But however you can do it is fine. It doesn't need to be perfect. We're just kind of curving this to taste. So now fold this over and make one last curving to taste. So it's like that. Okay, that looks pretty good. And now we're going to curve this part right here. So let's open here and just kind of push the flap in a little bit like this and try to make this fold end up right at this crease. And just try to mirror it on the bottom part so that the two edges come together like that. So I'm going to show you inside there, like that. Okay, now let's turn over and fold this edge to this edge. And turn back over. Now, let's fold this flap up so that the fold originates here, and we want to fold this edge onto this edge. So it's like that. And now fold it back. We're folding on this point, and we want to fold it so that this edge aligns with itself. Like that. Now let's tuck this flap into the pocket. And now we're going to make a little fold, just a pinch mark right at that corner there. We're going to call that point point A, and we're going to fold point A to point B. So just bring it up so that that pinch mark touches that point and flatten. I'm going to show you from the other side. You see this edge doesn't line up with itself. Turn back over. And now let's fold this flap so that the fold goes between this point and this point. So the idea is that all three of these lines converge. Okay, now we're going to fold like this so that the fold aligns with this edge. And let's fold this up about like this. This is to taste. You could maybe fold it a little bit more like this. Okay, now we're going to make a fold that goes from this point to somewhere in the middle here. So reach in and we're going to reverse fold it. Just make that mountain fold first. goes right like that. And now just flatten it. And then this extra part that's sticking out, you could either fold it inside or fold it on the bottom. I guess I'll fold it on the inside. Okay, now this looks okay, but it's kind of straight. So let's add one more curve to it. So open up here and make a little pleat somewhere in the middle. So like that, and just like that, a minuscule pleat. And close it back up. And now you can just kind of bend it a little bit. And that looks a little bit better. Okay, good enough. All right, let's work on this part. So now we're going to make a fold that goes from here, and we're lifting up these layers. So the fold goes from this point, and we want to fold it so that the three, I don't know what this is called in Hindi, but I'm going to call this the three. We want it to curve, so about like that. You could fold it a little bit more or a little less. It's to taste. But the fold should end up right at this point. And now flatten it, squash it, so that this is a right triangle, or at least an isosceles triangle. Okay, so it's like that. Now comes a cool step. We're gonna take this flap, the interior flap, and just fold it down like that. And now refold it, sticking it underneath. Like that. And you see how that edge just comes into shape. Okay, now let's take this flap, this little interior flap here, and fold it up to this point where the crease touches this edge. Like that. And you can kind of fix that up a little bit. And fold this little tippy tip behind. So it's like that. Okay, now let's work on this part here. So we want to try to make a curved line that attaches the two. So you could just kind of fold like that, but I'm going to do it a little bit more carefully. Open here and make a little pleat and try to make it so that these three edges coincide, and then fold up here. I don't really have any guidelines for this part, so you're kind of on your own. So we're making a little pleat like that, and do the same sort of thing over here. So we're folding from this pleat and fold it down like this, and you can just kind of make little pleats like that. You're kind of on your own on this one. I mean, just try to make this attach like that. Now, on the Aum symbol, at least the one that I have, this is closer to here. So what you can do is do this, turn over and fold this edge so that it aligns with this edge. And now fold this flap up so that the fold originates at this point and we want this point to touch this edge. Like that. And turn back over and put this flap on top and open these edges. And now you can just kind of rearrange them, try to do it as neatly as possible. So it's like that. And if you want this corner to come a little bit closer to here, you can just slide it over a little bit more, like that. And you can just kind of tuck this flap behind. That looks okay. It's a little bit messy in here, but oh well. Okay, that's a little bit better. And I'm gonna just fold this corner behind a little bit. I'm just shaping it to taste. Okay, that looks pretty good. All right, so there we have it, pretty much all done. And if you want to make it stand, then this is what you can do. Turn over and open this pocket and try to make it stand on these three points. So open it out so that when you let go, these three points form a triangle, and that's going to be the base for which it stands. Hopefully. Okay, let's see. Oops, I lost some flaps here. Okay, so there it stands pretty well like that. If you feel like it's leaning over too much to the right, then what you can do is turn back over and fold this edge up so that it's like this, it comes to this point. And that way, instead of here, it just goes a little bit more to the left. And what I like about this is that this kind of stays up a little bit. It's not touching the ground. I don't know, I just think that's kind of neat. Oops, at this point we want to come in front. So it's like that. And what else? If you want it to be a finger puppet, then undo this flap and fold this whole flap up like this between these two points and put your finger in here and fold it like this so that it grabs your finger. Turn over and there we have the Aum finger puppet. So, ooh, and it stands like this on this edge. So there you have it. Well, I hope you guys managed to fold this. I know it was a bear to design. So if you did manage to fold it, then congratulations. And if not, well, I hope you at least appreciate that I attempted to fold such a complex symbol and a symbol from a different culture than my own. And so there you have it. Aum. Have a great day. Bye bye.